Let us discuss antecedent and consequent rules. So these are the rules specifically for the automatic theorem proving only. These rules will not be applicable for the earlier methods. So last video, if you can recollect, we are discussing a terminology called theorem. So what is the definition of theorem? All axioms are theorem. That is the first point. Suppose if alpha is a theorem and beta is derived from alpha by applying the following rules, I said. So these are the rules. Okay, these are the antecedent. There are 5 antecedent rules and 5 consequent rules. So alpha is a theorem, and I derived beta from alpha using one of these rules as 5 antecedent rules and followed by, we are discussing now, 5 consequent rules. Then beta is also called as a theorem. So in that context, now let us see what are these antecedent and the consequent rules. Okay, yeah. Now listen carefully. Though the rule here, this rule is rule negation before logical sequence. So how you read this? This is the negation before logical sequence. Now though the rule here is if alpha comma beta logical sequence to x comma gamma, then alpha comma negation of x comma beta logical sequence to gamma, right? So 100% when you read this, you don't understand anything. It's more or less like a Greek and Latin, right? In fact, all these are Greek letters, alpha, beta, gamma. So, but what is the meaning of this rule? Let's understand. Okay. And one more point is, all these rules, please don't remember from left to right. You should remember then part, then followed by the if part. I'll tell you that in the next video why, but see, the meaning here is, here alpha, beta, gamma are some string of formulas. First point. What is string of formula? Like A comma, B comma, C is a string of formula. Formula separated with a comma is a string of formula. So here alpha, beta, gamma are mentioned just for the sake of generalizing the concept. That means there are some formulas. But here in this formula, our focus is on negation of x. Our focus is on negation of x. That means if negation is there before the logical sequence, that is the rule. Negation is there before the logical sequence, then how we remove this negation? Basically, in these rules, what we study is we try to remove the connectors. Okay. So to remove this negation, what you have to do? This alpha is as it is, beta is as it is, and gamma is as it is. This negation of x you take to the right side. So therefore, that is the reason x is here. Something like minus x on the left hand side, if you take to the right side, that becomes plus x, right? Similarly, here also, negation of x on the left hand side, if you take to the right side, that becomes normal x. Okay. So this is negation before logical sequence. So here in this process, what you are studying is how to remove negation, how to remove and, how to remove or, how to remove implication, how to remove by implication. Okay, and these 5 connectors, if they are before logical sequence, how to remove, and if they are after logical sequence, how to remove. So that is the reason we have 5 antecedent rules and 5 consequent rules. Okay, and first of all, why we need to remove these connectors? Because in the automatic theorem proving, all are string of formulas. Something like A comma B comma C sequence to P comma Q comma R, right? So there is no connectives at all. So that is the reason we want to replace these connectives with the string of formulas. So therefore, the first point is how to remove negation. So if negation is existing before logical sequence, then you take that negation of x to the right side so that that becomes the normal x. So please remember from right to left. Right to left. You have to remember from right to left. Okay. Now let us see the next formula, if the connective and is present before logical sequence. So that means alpha, beta, gamma, they are existing. Some formulas are existing. But however, we are focusing on this. That is the reason I have mentioned the bold. Okay, x and y. Suppose if x and y is present before this logical sequence, then how I remove this? And of course, this lot of research has done by that mathematician Wang. So he has given this formula. Okay. So So how to replace this? And so it's very simple. Alpha, beta, gamma. Again, I'm telling they will be always sitting in their position. So don't worry by seeing alpha, beta, gamma. Our focus is only on this x and y. So this and will be removed just by replacing with a comma. And will be removed by replacing with a comma. That too, and is existing before logical sequence. If and is there after logical sequence, then how to remove? That is a different rule. That comes under a consequent rule. Okay. Then, R before logical sequence. That means alpha, beta, gamma are there. Now we are focusing on X, R, Y. So this X, R, Y is there before logical sequence. Then we get two rules equivalently. One is X you keep left side and keeping alpha, beta, gamma as it is in their position. And the second one is, second formula is keep Y. So alpha, X, beta to gamma and alpha, Y, beta to gamma. Okay, so how I remove R if that is existing before logical sequence, let's say X, R, Y I have. Then how I remove? Keep X once and remaining alpha, beta, gamma as it is. Then the next formula, keep Y and remaining formulas are as it is. So X once and Y once. Remaining things are as it is. So this is how we remove R. And of course, equivalently, we get two formulas, one and two. Then suppose if I have implication before logical sequence, how I remove? Something like this. X implies Y is present before the logical sequence. I already told you many times. Alpha, beta, gamma, they are written just for the sake of generalizing the concept. That means X implies Y is here. Between before that, some content is there. After that, also some content is there. But our focus is on how to remove this X implies Y. Okay. So this is how we remove. Then again, we get to keep Y in the left side, ignoring X. Then the second one is keep X on the right side, ignoring Y. And the remaining alpha, beta, gamma, again, they will be sitting. All these rules, alpha, beta, gamma, they will be sitting in their position only. You should always see on the characters. Okay, so how we remove? Y on the left side, ignoring X. That is one rule. And the second rule is X on the right side, ignoring Y. So that is the reason we got two. Similarly, by implication, if by implication existing before logical sequence, that is X by implies Y, of course, alpha, beta, gamma again. There are some string of formulas are present. So in that case, X, comma, Y, you write once on the left side. Then X, comma, Y, once you write on the right side also. So you get two. So you please remember once again, all these rules you have to remember from right to left. So write down this expression. Then maybe you add if then. Okay. Then you add. But the way you remember is first remember the then part, then if part. I'll tell you why also in the next video. Okay, so all these five are antecedent rules. That means if not and or implies by implies, they present before the logical sequence, then how to remove? How to remove that we discussed. Okay, now let us see consequent rules. Okay. So consequent rules means what? All these, suppose if all these connectives they present after the logical sequence, how will it? So negation after logical sequence. That means it's something like this. Negation of X is there right side of the logical sequence. Then how we remove? Simply take this negation to the left side. So therefore, it is alpha, X, beta, gamma, gamma. Please observe carefully. Alpha, beta, gamma, again, they are sitting in their positions. Okay. Similarly, if and is present after the logical sequence, something like X and Y I have here. And of course, some formulas are here, alpha, beta, gamma. Okay, that means X and Y on the right hand side, before that some string of formula is there, after that some string of formula is there, which we are not bothering now. Our botheration is how to remove this part. So if and is there after the logical sequence, then you write X once on the right side and Y once on the right side, something like R in the antecedent case. Okay, so we get two here. And similarly, if you have R after logical sequence, something like X, R, Y, then you just replace with comma, remaining everything is as it is. So R will be replaced with a comma. If R is present, right side the logical sequence. Okay, there we replace with comma. If and is present before the logical sequence, then we replace with a comma. So all these formulas somehow we have to remember. Then implication. If implication is present after logical sequence, something like X implies Y I have here. Of course, alpha is here, beta, is here and gamma is here, then in that case, this x you take to the left side and keep y as it is on the right side. So therefore, see, x is coming here, y is coming here. Okay. Then you may ask why we are doing like this. Means it is already informed you. It is the research done by that mathematician man. Okay. If you follow these rules, then only when you apply on the given problem, automatically it will be solved. So he did a research and he has given a formulas. He released a formula. So if implication is present after logical sequence, so you do like this. So that is the reason. So he has published these formulas. And last one, by implication. Suppose if by implication is present after the logical sequence, something like x by implies y. Of course, alpha, beta, gamma again, they are in different positions. Then x on the left side and y on the right side once. Y on the left side, x on the right side once. And of course, remaining all are as it is. Okay. So these are the 5 antecedent rules and the 5 consequent rules. So I want every one of you, I request every one of you, please practice these formulas from right to left. That too. Okay. Please practice the formulas right to left. Write once, twice in your notebook without seeing. Then only you listen the next video so that when I apply in the next video, we'll see some examples where we apply this automatic theorem proving concept to prove a certain inferences. Okay, so if you want to enjoy that thoroughly, so you must practice all these 5 consequent rules and 5 antecedent rules. If you are thorough, then only you will be enjoying this next examples. Okay. So thank you all.